Who is your top offensive player at the midway point of the Big Ten season?
Could it be anybody else?
No.
But Dwayne Haskins.
It could not.
I mean, Dwayne Haskins is on a tear, to say the least. 25 touchdown passes, 4 interceptions, completing over 70% of his passes. The guy does not zone in on one guy either, whether it's Paris Campbell, KJ Hill. We saw Terry McLaurin make a lot of plays early in the season. Victor made that huge play against Penn State. He has looked so great. It's indescribable how good he looks. I run out of adjectives to even talk about it.
And how about the deep ball that he throws? I'll make a statement a little bit later about what I think of him as a passer. But he throws the deep ball. He puts so much air under it, right, and yet it continues to travel and travel. And with the speed of those Ohio State wide receivers, it has turned into an absolutely perfect marriage. Midseason defensive player of the year, according to J Leman, is whom?
Oh, you got to look at the top defense in the conference, if not the country, and that's the Michigan Wolverines and Chase Winovich. Chase Winovich at the defensive end position, not just the numbers, okay? He's got 10.5 tackles for losses. He's got 3 sacks. 35 tackles for a defensive end. That means you're hustling from the defensive end position. But here's the deal. When you're a defensive lineman, it's more than that. It's about being disruptive. You turn the tape, number 15 with the blonde hair, one of the most disruptive players in all of college football. When he doesn't make the play, he's oftentimes the reason the play is made. He's a leader. This is the guy that you would draft number 1 out of the Big Ten if you're trying to build a football team in the Big Ten Conference.
He's also got unbelievable hockey-style flow. I think it's even better than J. Layman circa 2007.
He's got longer flow. It's blonder.
Yeah.
But
it becomes better.
Is flow based on length or based on volume? Because mine was more voluminous, I felt like.
Yeah, I think he gets the extra points for the blonde. Let's go to the young fellas. Man, there are some good freshmen in this league. Who is the top freshman at midseason?
I went back and forth between Adrian Martinez because he put some great numbers. But for me, it's got to be Rondell Moore. I don't think there's a player that makes a defensive coordinator change their game more than Rondell Moore. Whether he's carrying the ball in the jet sweep or catching the ball in a little route and getting tons of yak because he can make people miss in space. And he's powerful, too. Breaks a lot of tackles, right? This guy has a lot of all-purpose yards. The exact game breaker that Jeff Brohm needed to recruit, and he sure did recruit him, got him out of his old high school in Kentucky. This guy is so far the top freshman in the conference.
Because he can do it in so many different ways.
Right.
I love the fact that Howard Griffith keeps going back each and every week to the fact that he thinks he's going to break his own Big Ten record for all-purpose yardage and go over that 400-yard mark. We're still waiting, but Rondale has been really good. I think this was the hardest of the four.
Right.
Big Ten Coach of the Year at midseason.
Well, there's a lot of candidates that were interim that I thought about. You know, Ryan Day was 3-0.
Not eligible.
Matt Canada's 4-2.
Probably is eligible because he's still the
as an
head
interim
coach.
Head coach, and I took a bad loss against Michigan, got beat pretty badly. But for me, it's James Franklin. No, I never thought Coach was a psychopath, although after that, you know, press conference of Ohio State, he claimed that some of them thought. I never thought that. I thought you were a great coach, and I love your tweets every Sunday about who you're playing next because it's all about the 1-0 mentality. But when you lose your top 3 players like Saquon Barkley, Mike Gesicki, and, of course, Deshaun Hamilton, and you're still able to compete at the highest level, up 2 touchdowns against Ohio State in the 4th quarter, not able to finish. And what I love about James Franklin, not satisfied. They're a great team. According to him, they're not an elite team, but he's the coach to take him there. He's got one of the best trigger men in the country in Trace McSorley.
And the recruiting continues to be outstanding. We thought, and Joe Moorhead is clearly showing down in Mississippi State,
good coach,
that he's a really good coach. We thought there would be a drop-off there. James Franklin was very confident, placing Ricky Ronnie, promoting him to be the offensive coordinator. We've seen great things out of Trace McSorley without all those players. Again, I'll stress it, important game for them to take care of business this weekend at home against Michigan State.